Bonjour. In today's video, you are going to learn about the French past tense, the imperfect. The imperfect stresses the duration of an action, not the fact that this action is over. This is the function of the passé composé under the past tense. The imperfect covers functions that are carried out in English by the simple past and the past continuous. It is used to refer to past habits or traditions, for instance, quand j'étais petite, je mangeais du poisson tous les vendredis. When I was a child, I used to eat fish every Friday. Make descriptions in the past. For example, Blanche-Neige était belle, elle avait la peau blanche comme la neige. Snow White was beautiful, her skin was as white as snow. And stress the duration of an action, notably if this action is interrupted by a brief action at the passé composé. For example, les enfants étudiaient quand le téléphone a sonné. The children were studying when the phone rang. So by now, you may have noticed some patterns in the formation of the imperfect, notably the ending in AI. But concretely, how do you form the imperfect? Take the stem of the first person plural at the present indicative, without ONS, and add the endings AIS, AIS, AIT, IONS, IEZ, AIENT. For instance, parler, to talk, at the imperfect. Je parlais, tu parlais, ils, elles, on parlait, nous parlions, vous parliez, ils, elles parlaient. This works for almost every verb, even the ones that are irregular at the present tense. For instance, avoir, nous avons at the present, j'avais, the imperfect. Faire, nous faisons, je faisais. Prendre, nous prenons, je prenais, and so on. The only exception is, unsurprisingly, être. Its stem is I with an acute accent, T. J'étais, tu étais, il, elle, on était, nous étions, vous étiez, ils, elles étaient. However, there are a few cases that are peculiar. The stem of verbs in CER changes at the first and second persons plural. The C with a cedilla becomes just C, because we don't need a cedilla to make the S sound. The I is enough. For instance, commencer, nous commençons with a cedilla, je commençais with a cedilla, but nous commencions, vous commenciez, without a cedilla. Likewise, the stem of verbs in GER changes at the first and second persons plural. GE becomes just G because we don't need the E to make the J sound. The I is enough. For instance, manger, nous mangeons with an E, je mangeais with an E, but nous mangions, vous mangiez, without an E. At the first and second persons plural, verbs in IER take two I's, the one of the stem and the one of the ending. For instance, étudier, nous étudions, j'étudiais, so one I, but nous étudions, vous étudiez, with two I's, but the pronunciation is similar to the present. Finally, a few words on the translation of the imperfect. In order to stress the incompletion, the duration or progression of an action, use the past continuous, especially in sentences where the imperfect is used with other tenses. For instance, la nuit dernière, tu dormais quand l'alarme incendie a sonné. Last night, you were sleeping when the fire alarm rang. For verbs for which the past continuous does not work well, such as to be, to have, to love, and so on, use the simple past. And for past habits, traditions, repetitions, and so on, use the simple past or used to or would. For instance, avant, les femmes portaient un chapeau. In the past, women wore hats, or women used to wear hats, or women would wear hats. Au revoir! Created using Powtoon.